Hi there, YouTube. I want to show you another way to outpaint. And so you're probably used to using open outpaint, but I can't figure out how to work this thing. And then it just doesn't want to do what I'm asking it to do. And a lot of times I'll get some naked anime girls instead of extending my picture in any direction. For those of you that don't know what outpainting is when you extend the canvas of your picture and start painting in more of that picture. So it's almost like that picture was always a bigger picture to begin with. So my method is going to consist of using your inpainting to do your outpainting. I know it doesn't make any sense, but you're going to see it and it's going to make a lot of sense and it's going to be a lot easier than using this thing. In the past, I got this thing to work, but right now it just seems to be acting kind of crazy and I don't have the time to figure it out. So I'm going to use my method. All right, all you got to do is open up Stable Diffusion, then click on the image to image tab right here. Now drag in the photo that you want to outpaint with and just put it right there in the image to image box. Now click on the little pencil button right above the picture, and this is so we can edit the canvas and extend it a little bit. So I'm going to grab the canvas and you can extend it in whatever direction you want. I'm going to go to the left. I usually do this so I can edit my YouTube thumbnails and I could put some words in here. But the next thing we need to do is scroll down a little bit, and I recommend clicking outside in the blank space twice just so you don't scroll up and down inside the photo like this, because it's kind of hard to get it back to the right. I don't know why it doesn't get back to the right size. Usually I just end up clicking out and then adding the photo again. All right, now that I'm not scrolling inside the canvas, I'm going to scroll down a little bit here to the height and width sliders. And I'm just going to click on this thing and it'll automatically choose the resolution for the canvas that I chose. And for now, I'm going to set the denoising strength all the way down to 0. And now I'm going to click on generate. And there we go. We got the same picture with an extended bar on the left side here, which is what I wanted. So we're going to go ahead and click on send this to Inpaint. And this is the image that we're going to work with now. All right, so now we want to click on this color palette thing and then choose the color white, or just another color that we could see inside this black area. Cool trick here is if you hold control and you scroll up, you'll increase your brush size, and you could do it the other way too. But I want it big, just like this, and I'm going to go ahead and paint inside that black area right here and just fill it in as best as you can. You just make sure it's all gone, no more black. All right, so we got it filled in. Now we want to scroll down a little bit and go to the denoising strength and raise it up to about like 0.40, somewhere around there. And you want to change the mask content to fill. And this is probably like one of the rare times that you'll actually change this to fill instead of original. And these are all the default settings for inpainting. And just real quickly here. So the mask mode, you want inpaint mask. And for mask content, you want, normally you want original, but this time we're going to choose fill. And then for inpaint area, you want the whole picture, which is a little weird because the whole picture means you're painting inside the area that you mask. Then only mask means the opposite, which is, I don't get that logic, but whatever. It does what it does. So I'm not going to touch anything else, and you could tweak these settings as much as you want. Now all we got to do is scroll back up and click generate. The results are out and it looks okay, but I think that we can do better here. So I don't know what this thing is and why this person is there. And also it's a little bit two-tone, but it's very easy to fix. So we're just trying to get an okay image and then we'll iterate on that photo. So I want to try a bunch of different options. So what I'm going to do is go all the way to the bottom. And if you ever watched my channel, you probably saw this trick before, but go ahead and go to scripts and go to an XYZ plot. And for the other two, Y and Z is going to be none. And for the X type, we're going to put denoising. And then for the X values, we're going to put 0.2 to 0.8. So what this means is that the denoising scale is going to be tested from 0.2 to 0.8. And then we put 20 in parentheses 20 times. So there's going to be 20 variations between that range. So now we're going to get 20 pictures. So I don't have to sit here dragging this back and forth, testing every value. And now I'm just going to click generate. All right, so my testing is done. So I could look at all the pictures that were created now. So I'm going to go ahead and see what is the best sweet spot for denoising on this picture. It made a lot of pictures. And as you can see here, it doesn't really start to give us what we want until we're over about 0.48 denoising. Now let's do it latent upscale so it does the whole thing at once. So send this to image and scroll down and then lower your denoising strength and then turn on your seed, which is this green recycle button, which will give you a seed. And we want our denoising strength around 0.05, not 0.5, 0.05. And we're also going to lower our CFG scale. I think 3.5 will be okay. And then now I'm going to click on generate one more time. As you can see, it meshed in the inpainted side a little bit better, but we can actually just kind of keep iterating till we get what we want. But you get the idea. But that's how you do it. And so I have some details, but let's try upping the denoising strength a little bit. So you don't want to change the picture too much. So I'm going to try 0.15. But the higher you can go, the better this thing will mesh. All right, so let's look at it now. So although it does look good, I mean, it changed some details on her face and on her body, which I don't want. So I'm going to go back down a little bit. Okay, so I think I got a result that I'm happy with. So I'm just going to do a final upscale. And when you do the final upscale, you want to raise the sampling steps. So I'm going to put it around 60-ish, and then I'm going to use DPM++ 2S Keras, and any of those models are pretty good. And Euler A is more for when you're kind of prototyping, and then when you get a final image, you want to use one of the more advanced sampling methods with a higher sampling step. All right, so I have this. And also one more thing I wanted to point out is that I actually just used the model that I used to create this picture. I don't use the Inpainting model. I do have it, but I just feel like it's a waste of time. And sometimes it doesn't generate better results. All right, so let me click generate and see what we end up with. Okay, so here's the final picture. And if you remember, this whole side here on the left, starting from where the girl's hair is, didn't exist before. And so we outpainted this entire side here and extended the sword and added these rocks and everything on the left here. So that's how you can outpaint with Inpainting. I know it's a little weird, right? But that's how you can do it. And it's the easier way. You don't have to install anything. And it comes up with great results. And you can keep iterating and drawing in a mask and do it over and over again with reduced denoising to get better results. So if you're having trouble with outpainting, definitely try this trick. I just want to mention that I use the term upscale in this video, and I use the term pretty loosely. And what I'm referring to is the latent upscale, which will improve the quality, but it's not going to improve the resolution. By that, I mean if you zoom all the way in, it's still going to be pixelated. If you want to improve the resolution, you can head over to the extras tab and then you can upscale it that way. But what I recommend is checking out my video on upscaling, and you can upscale up to 8K. So you can get images from 8192 to 8192, which is insane quality. That's like in your face. That's like zoom all the way in and not see any pixelation. So you should definitely check out that video, and I'll leave it in my video description. But let's do outpainting on one more image, and let's do it real quickly this time. First, I need to create an image. So I'm gonna go to text to image and create something. All right, so I quickly created a cool image right here, and I used the Azovia RPG artist tools. And this is what creates these types of pictures if you're interested in this type of like orc and high fantasy, dark fantasy type of stuff. And it's a 1x1 image right now. And the way I created that is I actually got this pose using control net. So I used Leonidas, and then I used open pose to just kind of get that yell right here. And I put in a very simple prompt with just, you know, some negative prompts here, and it came out this way. So that looks pretty good to me. And I had to do some inpainting because it didn't look like this in the background. I had to make a lot of changes, as well as changes to her skin, which I think I missed the part. So let me just fix that. Just fill that in, then type in green orc skin or something like that. And if it doesn't want to change, go ahead and up the denoising strength. You can go pretty high if it's just like a small section that you're working on. And you can also change the seed to a random seed by clicking on the dice to make sure you can get those changes. So I got the change I want. I think that's good enough. Actually, let me up it a little bit and try it one more time. All right, so that's good enough for me. So now I'm going to click on send to image, and then click on the edit button, and then go ahead and extend the canvas in the direction you want to outpaint and extend the image. So I'm going to extend it to the left so I can make a little YouTube thumbnail here. Now click outside of the box, and if you want to be sure, just click in one of the prompts, and then you could scroll down. Now go ahead and go to height and width, and then click on the silver bar to do the auto resolution thing. So now it's 708 by 512. And I'm going to put the denoising strength to 0 because we just want to create that black bar on the side right now. And I'm going to click generate. Cool. Now we have the image with the black bar, and we're going to send it to Inpaint. And then in Inpaint, we're going to go ahead and color it in that black section right here. Make sure you overlap a little bit into the actual image. You don't want to do like a clean cutoff. So it's good to make it crooked a little bit. All right, so that's good enough. Now scroll back down to denoise and then up the denoising to about like around 0.5, 0.4, somewhere in between there, and then click on fill instead of original, and then click on generate. All right, so after a little bit of testing, 0.63 seems to be the sweet spot, and it came up with a pretty good image. But if I didn't like what it gave me, I would actually send this to Inpaint, and then we would iterate on this image by coloring in this section and then scrolling down a little bit and changing it from fill to original, because now it's not blank. So we're just actually kind of inpainting over what's already there. And then click generate. And then if you got something that didn't mesh, which this meshes pretty good, you can actually send it to image, and then you could turn on the seed and set the denoising strength pretty low, about 0.7 or something, and just click generate again. I would try it with or without the seed. Sometimes it just matters on the model that you're using. So if you're using the regular Stable Diffusion model, I think the seed would help. But I think for the model I'm using, it's actually better to leave it off. But yeah, so this is the picture that I'm going to work with for my thumbnail. And I just got to do some fine touch-ups on Inpainting, and then this will be good to go. I'm going to show you one last method, and this is kind of like a bonus. I'm going to use Leonardo.ai for this one. And if you don't know about Leonardo AI, check out my video on Leonardo AI, Playground AI, and Blue Willow. And these are all free AI art generators that you can use right now. So I'm going to launch the app because I already have access to this. And I'm going to say, yes, I'm whitelisted. And you could see the pictures this thing makes is beautiful and even has the ability to do some training. So you can actually train images. And there's a lot of functionality to the tools in here. They even have their own version of Leonardo Diffusion, which is similar to Midjourney. They have Dream Shaper, Deliberate, which I use a lot. They have RPG 4.0. So this is a pretty cool app. And you got quite a few free images per day. Once you're in Leonardo AI, just go ahead and go into AI Canvas. As you can see here at the top right, you got 150 credits. And it's going to take about two or three for each generation because it's going to have four different images that are generated. You'll see in a second. So let's upload an image we want to extend or outpaint on. So I'm simply just going to drag and drop the photo onto the canvas. And there it is. Now you don't want to go too far off with this box. You want to just outpaint a little bit at a time. So I'm going to outpaint about two columns here so you could see this one and this one. So that's about two. I think that's actually all we need. And just make sure it lines up so you don't get a crooked photo. And then type whatever you want to see on the side there. So I'm going to put High Fantasy Castle in the snow in the background, and I'm going to click generate, and it's going to take four tokens. Okay, so it gave me an image here. It's very different. So let me try clicking on each one, and I don't like any of these. Let me try it again, but I'm going to reduce the size of the square. So I'm going to click cancel. All right, so I have another generation. Let me see what it gave me. This one's okay. However, you can mess around with the guidance scale here to get some better results. And so let me try five and try that out. And this one's okay. This one's acceptable, but I want to try something better. Okay, there we go. These are nicer results. So here we have four different results. I'm going to go with this one. So I'm going to click accept and then go ahead and click on the download button. There you go. You got your extended image. Super easy, and you don't even need Stable Diffusion. So that's all I had today. And if you liked it, go ahead and leave a thumbs up. And thanks for watching. Take it easy. Bye.